Welcome! In this video, you will learn about governance ethics, a model of relations between economics and ethics developed by Joseph Wieland. Morality is here a part of economic system, so it is contained in all economic situations and actions. Let's say that the producer of ventilators used for hospitalized corona patients, seeing that demand is growing, raises the price. This may be efficient from an economic point of view, but the moral content of this decision for Wieland transaction is a bad one, because due to such an action, many patients will die. Similarly, we can imagine an organization that achieves results important to producing the vaccine. In order to secure its future profit, it does not share this with others. Again, economically it may make sense, but morally not. A dissemination of the results may lead to much faster development of a vaccine and to the saving of many lives. This time, economically, it may be not so profitable, but morally good. So each decision gives us different information. There may also be an economic action, such as stopping sewing brass and starting to sew protection masks, which may make both economic and moral sense. In Wieland's model of transactions, there is an economic and ethical channel. The economic channel uses the economic language of profit efficiency. The ethical channel uses the language of morality, good and bad. The communication in the company, when only the economic channel is used, may cause much harm, especially in the long term. A company which makes an ethical failure risks paying high penalties. Also, employers are not always motivated by the economic channel, especially when their basic needs are already covered. So, the company needs to activate the moral channel and be aware of the presence of morality in economic transactions. What can you do as a company to implement a moral choice? Can the state, institutions and culture of the society help you to lower the cost of implementation? The following equation may help you to understand. Each transaction has its moral dimensions, TM, which is a function of four variables. IIs, FI, II, CCM. The first, individual self-bounding, tells us to what extent there are already people in the company who are virtuous and know and act according to what is good and bad, and behave accordingly. When IIs is high, it will mean that you have employees acting virtuously and you don't need to control them at each step. Secondly, formal institutions, FI, tell us to what extent the activity of the company is regulated by rules and laws which are enforced. If FI are strong, you can, for instance, return damaged goods bought by your suppliers and get compensation. Thirdly, informal institutions, II, tell us how strong the expectations of society is towards the behavior of people and towards the economic activity of enterprises. Strong informal institutions may have an ambiguous effect. If your employees are taught by their families that colored people or women or people with a different sexual orientation are worse than their race, their gender, etc., your company may have difficulties in creating good communication, but will create a climate in your company which will hinder economic activity. The impact may be positive too. If informal institutions regulate positive communication between people, imposing mutual respect, etc., more often, society may expect that suppliers of the company do not use child labor, provide equal pay for their workers, etc. So there is strong pressure on the competitors of your company and on you, which facilitate your introducing such rules. Coordination and Cooperation Mechanism of an Organization, CCM, tell us about the extent to which a company introduces coordination rules as business codes and other regulations which improve the internal communication. The letters A, B, C, D tell us about the positive or negative role of each of the variables in the company. So if the letters take -1 value, this means that the particular variable has a negative impact on the moral content of the transaction. And usually it will be compensated by other variables. On the contrary, +1 means that the variable has a positive impact on the moral dimension of the company. So let's say that in your company there are some virtuous employees working efficiently, highly intrinsically motivated, not watching their smartphones every 5 minutes. Moreover, there are highly observed formal institutions, norms, rules, and positive informal institutions. So the values of IS, FI, and II are +1. And you don't have to invest much money in CCM, whereas if they are negative, you have to bear a lot of costs to maintain the moral dimension of the transaction. This equation informs us as well about various ethical approaches in business. The table below presents this in a more systemized way. So, for instance, virtue ethics accentuates the IS variable. System ethics is more focused in good formal institutions. Global ethics sees the source of change in informal institutions such as culture, mental models, etc. Governance ethics focuses on cooperation and coordination mechanisms which exhibit the situational component of moral action, as I explained to you in previous lectures, such as, for instance, the principal agent problem that shows the negative impact of asymmetry of the information on transactions costs. This may be evaded by investments in CC. So, to summarize, according to Wieland, each of the transactions has its moral dimension, and you as the organization have to see to which extent there are mechanisms which secure it. He differentiated 4 factors: self-bonding mechanism, formal and informal institutions, and cooperation and coordination mechanisms. All these 4 factors build the starting point of various approaches to ethics like virtue, system, global, and governance ethics. For Wieland, the most effective approach which the company has impact on is CCM, coordination and cooperation mechanisms, which may be introduced by business ethics codes, for instance. Thank you.